Hi everyone, our next topic is scanning electron microscope.
Before going to the topic, please subscribe my channel, press the bell icon for notifications, like, share among your friends and comment.
Scanning electron microscope is a type of electron microscope which can scan surfaces of organs or organism by using beam of electrons. The secondary electron produced by the specimen are detected to generate an image that contains topological features of the specimen. Here we can see the component or the parts of a scanning electron microscope. Here, electron source is there. In light microscope, we are using light beam, but here it is electron source, tungsten filament, lanthanum, hexaboride and field emission gum. Lenses. It has several condenser lenses that focus the beam of electrons from the source through the column, forming a narrow beam of electrons that form a spot called a spot size. Next one is scanning coil. They are used to deflect the beam over the specimen surface. Detector is made up of several detectors that are able to differentiate the secondary electron, backscattered electrons and diffracted backscattered electrons. The functioning of the detectors highly depend on the voltage speed, the density of the specimen. Next is the display device, mainly data output devices, then power supply and vacuum system. See, in the image, everything is labeled. When we examine the principle of scanning electron microscope, which apply kinetic energy to produce signal on the interaction of the electron. These electrons are called secondary electron, backscattered electron and diffracted backscattered electron. So these are used to view crystallized elements and photons. These secondary and backscattered electrons are used to produce an image. Here, secondary electrons emitted from the specimen play the primary role of detecting the morphology and topography of the specimen, while the backscattered electrons show contrast in the composition of the elements of the specimen. This slide explains the working of scanning electron microscope. Here, the specimen does not need special treatment for visualization under the SEM. Even air-dried sample can be examined directly, but for histological and or microorganism specimen need fixation, dehydration and drying in order to maintain the structural features of the cell and to prevent collapsing of the cell when exposed to the high vacuum of the microscope. Then the sample are mounted and coated with thin layer of heavy metal element to allow spatial scattering of electric charges on the surface of the specimen, allowing better image protection with high clarity. Scanning by this microscope is attained by tapering a beam of electron back and forth over a thin section of the microscope. Here, the specimen produces secondary electrons and backscattered electrons and that emit flashes of light which get converted into an electric current by a photomultiplier, sending a signal to the cathode ray tube. This produces an image that looks like a television picture that can be viewed and photographed. Next, we can see the applications of scanning electron microscope. Scanning electron microscope is used in energy dispersive X-ray spectroscopy, analysis of cosmetic components which are very tiny in size, to study the filament structure of microorganism and the topography of elements used in industries. Then next is the advantages. Easy to operate and has user-friendly interfaces, used in a variety of industrial applications to analyze surfaces of solid objects. Some modern SEM are able to generate digital data that can be portable. It is easy to acquire data from the SEM within a short period of time of about 5 minutes. Limitations are very expensive to purchase, bulky to carry, room should be free of vibrations and electromagnetic elements, maintained with a consistent voltage and access to cooling systems. Dear friends, thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and please subscribe my channel.